Hi, Harold. Look at that. Hi, Danny. How are you? Good. A little warm, but it's warm where I came from, too. Yeah. Boy, that's as smooth and quiet as they get, isn't it?
Kind of cold this morning.
Yeah.
That was made by the Franklin Motor Company.
Right, Franklin. Yeah, Franklin.
Franklin.
Yeah, they made the Parcellan Weed engines.
Yeah, the next one has that engine on the cylinder. Not on this one.
Uh-huh.
I don't know, Bill.
Yeah, that's a Parcellan Weed design. And that's those two flywheels in the middle. Each one's one of the crank arms.
Well, you don't have no brake then.
Right.
And then you don't need to make a brake then.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's quite a piece. Nice and quiet. And here's an early Parcellan Weed. It's been highly modified by our friend Harold's dad, Dick Siebert. He added a side shaft. He made all the parts for it, or acquired them and added them to it. Added a side shaft, which has 7 or 8 jobs. The shaft will run the water pump, keep it cool. And here you have a distributor drive. It has an ignition off an antique inboard motorboat motor. And here's an oiling system, kind of like what you find on the old autos. And it drives the governor, which is right here. See the governor right there. And you move along up the wall, it drives this here. There's a fuel pump. And here's the rocker arm for the exhaust valve. And here's the rocker and cam for the intake valve. Here's the rocker. There. And there's a magneto on the front, which is not hooked up today. It's running off the bugs coil you see right down there. Here's a screen cooler on the back. Right now this looks like a lubricator. It's a fuel supply. Running on gasoline. There's the carburetor over there. And that just about completes the tour of this pretty complex little engine.
I was kicking it, and I couldn't get no spark, so I put this on yesterday. That's a spark.
Okay.
And what I have to do to keep running is keep pouring fuel in here.
Okay.
It won't pump it out.
Okay, so you have a gravity feed that gets get your fuel down there.
To keep that pool.
Yep.
Goes down the carburetor to gravity feed.
Okay.
Can you see it at all?
It's about half an inch from the brass.
That's
top
probably close enough. Yeah, that's probably close enough.
Well,
we'll see if we get it started.
Yeah.
Anyway, Harold's father did an awful lot of work on this. I'll trade places with you. Geez, that's nice, Harold. With all that stuff and nothing's rattling.
Well, I took the kicker off. I didn't want to keep kicking. I'm not
sure.
Right. One on
okay, sure.
Oh, my wire fell off.
Oop. Loose wire? Yeah. Make sure that coil's off before you...
This is the great thing about a buzz coil. It keeps hitting you.
Oh, it'll let you know.
It's not just like one discharge.
Yeah.
You're not just awake, you're wide awake. All right.
I'll get out of your way. Just hang on
there. Well, I'll film it from this side right now. Gee, that runs as smooth as silk, too.
It gets better. It gets better when it gets warmed up. This is a
oiler. Yeah, like on the early autos.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, this stuff
he had it found. Nice antique brass carburetor. Sure.